Hi everyone, my name is Anshul and I'm a part of Azure Identity and Authentication team at Microsoft. This video is a quick demonstration understanding how Hard Match works in Azure Active Directory. Often we see errors such as attribute value must be unique when we try to sync a user from on-premises Active Directory to Azure AD or Office 365. No matter how hard we try, we cannot sync the user across. There might also be a situation where the UPN that we have set up in on-premises Active Directory differs from the UPN for the user in Azure Active Directory. And we have a duplicate object with same proxy address or UPN, or sometimes the sync either fails or creates a new account. To fix such issues, you might have to hard match an object. By the term hard match, we mean to explicitly snap the source anchor for a user account. If I had to say this in simpler terms, hard match is a process where you stamp the on-premises object quid as a base 64 string value on a cloud user so that Azure AD Connect 2 is eligible to identify the right account and sync or make changes to it. This process helps the tool to identify the correct user on Azure AD, so the next time the sync tool does not have to start the entire identification from scratch. To hard match a user, we follow these steps. Log on to the on-premises Active Directory and we get the object quid of the user. Either we can do that from the GUI or through PowerShell. We can use the command get-ad-user-identity from PowerShell. We obtain the value of the object quid, convert it into a base 64 string, which is then used as an immutable ID for the cloud user in Azure Active Directory. Now again, using the PowerShell, we log into Azure Active Directory module as a global administrator, and we update the immutable ID with the copied object quid of the on-premises Active Directory. After this, we allow the Azure AD Connect to run a sync cycle and sync the changes to Azure. Let us have a quick demonstration on how we can use the hard match. We have a user, Chris Matthews, which is created in Azure Active Directory. The user is a cloud-only user, and let's say we want to match this to another user in on-premises Active Directory. If you notice, the user's UPN is a non-routable domain suffix, which is contoso.local. In this case, we cannot do a UPN soft match, so we have to do a hard match here. We make a note of the object quid of the user and convert the value to base 64-bit string. In our case, we'll use PowerShell. So first, we need to import the Active Directory module, and once the module is loaded, we get the object quid of the user using the PowerShell command get-ad-user and store this in a variable. Next, we need to convert the value to base 64 string and store in another variable. After this, we connect to Azure AD with global admin credentials, and then we run set-Azure AD user command. We get the object ID of the Azure AD user and ensure that we update that in the PowerShell command. After that, we update the immutable ID that we copied in the previous step. Once we have updated the immutable ID of the user, we run a delta sync cycle on Azure AD Connect. After the sync cycle has been completed, we refresh and we can see in Azure AD that the on-premises sync enabled is now set to true for the user. Another interesting thing to notice here is that the UPN of this user has also been updated. This is because the DirSync feature synchronized UPN for managed user is set to true. And since the UPN in on-premises Active Directory for this user is a non-routable domain suffix, by design, the Azure AD user UPN is set to tenant domain suffix. There are a few things that we need to consider before hard match. We use hard match only if the soft match option is not working. It is not supported to update an immutable ID of a synced user. The immutable ID can only be updated for cloud-only users. We need to ensure that we make note of the source anchor from Azure Active Directory through configuration wizard to ensure we are picking the correct value when we want to do a hard match. based on the source anchor, we choose the appropriate attribute from on-premises Active Directory and take the necessary actions to convert it into the immutable ID. It's really important that we always update the correct value of immutable ID for a user, because updating an incorrect value can break the user object. It is also important that we update the correct value of immutable ID for a user account. Updating an incorrect value can result in breaking a user account, making it orphan, or also resulting in certain errors. You also need to ensure that Active Directory module and Azure Active Directory module is installed in PowerShell. Thank you for watching.